walk one daddy, you not file for me. Don't a yard, ya get too wild for me. Right now, me no like how things look for me. Them tell my friend life little most them took for me. Please, me a beg your daddy file for me. Because the place I get too hostile for me. Right now, me no like how things look for me. Them tell my friend life little most them took for me.
Wagwan people, hope everybody doing good. Yeah man, today is a special day for Jamaica, so I want to say happy independence. And respect to everybody who are tuning and subscribe to the channel likewise. But if you haven't done that as yet, please go ahead and do so now. Turn your post notification on by hitting that bell icon so you guys can be the first to be notified whenever I do an upload. So before we get into the official video itself, I want to congratulate the girls again. You see the parade, they're going with a bag of things. They won gold this morning in the 4x1 relay. Yeah man, not in record time, but they broke the national record, Jamaican record, and it was a good run. It's still free to see the girls going out there, putting their all on the track, and based on what we see, the chemistry with the girls, them have no normal. You see, it is just a happy vibes, good vibes, and them bring a lot of joy, especially on this special day for Jamaica. So it's a good look. Sorry that me can't provide you with the clippings of the race because copyright with the Olympics. But you guys can watch it on other platforms. It's all over social media, rather. So you can go up on social media, find it. A lot of people have it. But I want to say congratulations to the girls again. It's still free. But also, we have a whole clipping to provide now with. So on live TV, both girls basically dismiss the beef and explain what actually happened in the whole 100 meter situation with the pictures that we're seeing and the type of expression that we thought that we saw. So they basically explained that Sherika was in the mix. They did it on CNN. May I play the clippings? So make sure you stay tuned.
Video them and them bust out a head down ya. You know what you news? Be blood a shed down ya. From your go away, you say you a go send for me. What you a do? You a go wait till me dead down ya. Me a tell you say the thing a get hot on me. I mean no one a police sketch but with the strap on me. But some boy want put gunshot on me. Me a whoop on a turn your back on me.
So that was J Blunt, another bad dancehall artist. You see the free? Your man with a song called File For Me. He's basically a yardman type of a vibe. Is it yardman there Jamaica? Him daddy there foreign. Is it two of the place I run? Him dying for left out of the place. So him want go abroad. Go try to live a better life and see if him can survive. Because two of the place I run, the place just hot. And him no want to get fall night. Or probably they at the wrong place at the wrong time. Because we don't know the thing set up. But Analan's a good song. I like the song. Song we can vibe to amidst the mobile. It's the pre. Yeah man, so wanna go check out the song. Your song is out on all media platform. The link to this song will be pinned in the description. If someone wanna go check it out, also I'm gonna drop the link in the comment section for if it's easier for another way. They click on the link, go over my page, leave a like, leave a comment, share the video. You can follow me on Instagram just to see him at J Blunt. Yeah man, that'll be fine. Check out some other songs.
Walk one daddy, you know, file for me. Don't a yard, ya get too wild for me. Right now, me no like how things look for me. Them tell my friend life little most them cook for me. Please, me a beg your daddy file for me. Because the place I get too hostile for me. Right now, me no like how things look for me. Them tell my friend life little most them took for me.
It's a bad song, I know a whole lot of people can relate to that song, yeah. It's very relatable. If you are a Jamaican, and not also a Jamaican, but person from other country, because we don't know the thing set up. So the song is very relatable. And I know someone gonna like the song, and someone gonna check out the official song. Click on the link either in the description or the comment section to take you directly to the song itself. But
see me, daddy, me just want get a way out. Because my life in a danger, day in, day out. Me want go through the airport, too much nights me see.
So right now, I'm gonna check out the interview of the girls, them, Shelly and Ilian. Also, Sherika was in that interview. Basically, it was mainly about the 1-2-3. But you know, say with the media, them now go past the fact say, yo, some controversy surrounding the whole win. And with the images and everything, everybody having their own perception of what they thought was going on. You know, say that go spark some local controversy and everything. And that's what we've been talking about. So, me, I'm going to check out the clippings. Let's see the pre. But anyways, me have to play this. Check out a dancer from the four girls that won the 4x4. Mats.
No. Dirt. 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 Everybody get your bones, watch ya. Dirt. Dirt. Dirt.
Knowing that we get 1, 2, 3, I've seen that when I was not an elite athlete watching back home 2009 or 2008. So for us to repeat that once more, it's a good feeling to be a part of that history and to be amongst these ladies. It's a wonderful feeling.
So I guess I had the honor of being a part of both of those times. And you know, I'm just excited for all of us and what it means for the young girls back home like us can know that Jamaica can indeed at the next Olympic Games with Elaine and Sharika again can get 1, 2, 3. And I think it speaks to just the dominance and the legacy that we have in Jamaica, and I'm hoping that it continues for years to come.
What is it? How this island producing some of the most dominant Olympians we've ever seen? 13 of the last 15 medals available over the past 5 games in the women's sprint.
Look at us. Is that,
right here.
In the right.
How? Why?
I mean, it's awesome. I don't know. I think, boy, you know, God has been good to us. We are a blessed nation. And, you know, to be able to rise to the top of the world again, it's years of, you know, other athletes, Merlin Otte, you know, Dion Emmons, and all the other great athletes that we have seen and we continue to, you know, emulate. Like Elaine said, you know, she saw me when she was, you know, younger coming up. And then Sharika, now seeing us, decided to step down from the 400 and come to the 100 and join us. So, you know, remarkable.
Yeah, you are now those that youngsters are looking to. What's it going to be like? What kind of party is it going to be when you get back to the island?
I don't think there will be a party. I'm going to be honest, probably there will be a party, but
nobody will know.
Nobody will know. It'll be a surprise.
When I played in the NFL, I was not happy when one of my teammates edged me out for a starting spot in the game that week. How difficult is the dynamic for being teammates, yet you're also your biggest competitors? What's that like?
I think it's normal to be competitors and understand that we all want to win and we want to go out and we want to run our best race. And I think it's also normal for athletes to have emotions of disappointment. Not everybody is gonna be readily excited, or some persons, even when they win, they're not overly excited, because I think for a lot of them, they believe that, you know, they could maybe have done more, maybe something went wrong. But you know, that's what makes sports unique, and each individual that comes to the sport, that is what makes us, you know, unique and makes the dynamic of the competition very different. And I think it's okay that when you look back at the moment, you're still grateful, because it could have been worse. You know, it could not have been three of us. It could have been somebody else. And I'm sure the other ladies who were in the semifinals or the heats wish they were in the finals. So you still have to take what you can from it, even in your disappointment. You have to take the good from it. So I don't think there's any hard feeling. It just means that, you know, we all have to go in. I'm sure Elaine goes back and say, well, I'm going to work that much harder to make sure I stay in front. I'm going back to say, oh, well, I'm going back to work hard. And I think it's good, because if you have competitors that continues to push you, then you're able to get to the target that you set for yourself.
And honestly, to add to that, I know either if I didn't want, or Shelly won, or Jackson had won, we three gonna pull each other to the line same way, because we are watching each other. So I know we are all seeing each other, and we're just going, the three of us actually going.